I took notice of your questions, but I will answer as politician now. I will say the things I have to say. So, hello everybody. It's been a full day up to now, and we're asking for your attention once again. Let's see how this works. Okay. So yes, I'm Yanis from Samos, and it's been like 10 years, maybe a little bit more, than I first met Aiza. Maybe it was not even called Aiza these days. And we started working with a Greek interoperability framework. So those days we followed on what we used to call AIF 2.0, even 1.0, I remember a lot. And then off to AIF 3 and AIRA then. You know, let's be honest, the chapter about organizational interoperability is about legal, more or less, in every three of the European interoperability frameworks is more of a set of wishes than of a set of methods. So you can call it a problem maybe or a solution, but I will come to that again. So these days, as we learned also, and as we studied with Germany and with, I met guys from Denmark, we remembered the infrastructure base of these days. We tackled a lot on the semantics. And you all know that with SEMIC and all the work done up to now and all the schemas and the work done in Estonia and in other countries also, more or less we have a way to communicate. But you see, the process is the king here. Without really good, well-made processes, we cannot go very far. Then, of course, in Greece, you know, we had the crisis and we're still more or less inside. And we had to tackle other things. But now I can say I see an opening in Greece that we can call it, we can come back maybe in the same issue of organizational interoperability that we didn't manage too much. Maybe apart from the things that I will say in the second slide, Europe hasn't done so much in organizing itself and the member states on process issues. So the other problem, lesson number two, is that you know, the process redesign and alignment cannot be done in islands because everything is connected. I'm not sure if we can done it in a single state, in a single member state, or we need to solve the whole thing at the same time. But we're going to try, and in Greece now, we're just launching a new project, learning, of course, of as many experiences of you all from the past. We call it the reweaving, the business process reengineering, of all the processes in what we call local administration, so municipality and regional level, where the biggest problem of multiplicity and copying and reproducing processes and altering processes occurs all over Europe. We all know the recent example from Holland that they tried to make this list of services and included all the definitions, and they ended up with 30,000 types, 30,000 types of services between the state and the citizen and the businesses. So what we're trying to do here as a solution to the interoperability problem from the organizational point of view for a country, but I think that if we manage, there will be a lot of things to share with ESA and then maybe enlarge a little bit our standardization from a wishing list or a wish list to something much more concrete. Let me tell you what I mean here. The idea is to cover almost 2,000 service types. In every European member state, the number varies, but it's more than 1,000. But of course, we all know that many of the services need to be phased out now because they still service a non-interoperable system. You have all these certificates and copies and things that are not needed in a well-managed environment as the other Greek of the day, Lefteris, before, described having a true ESB operation and once only principle. So in order to do that, basically we have to restructure 2,000 processes. The problem is that no one knows how. You see, this is open even in literature. There is not enough research done the last 100 years on how to re-engineer services processes not belonging to the industry. The industry is well done. We know how to run production lines. Also, we know the algorithms of, you know, making a process look good. So this good design, this principle of well-designed processes is solved for some of the sectors, but not for the service sector. There is no one in my country or in my group anyway that says, hey, I have an algorithm with 100 steps that will take any process and give a well-designed one. So the target is to make this kind of algorithm set. And even, because I believe, as you can understand, in machines, even make this re-engineering, this reweaving from a 100% human process to make it a little bit less human and a little bit more assisted by decision support systems. The idea and the target of the whole exercise is something that would be very difficult for Greece before, to reach machine time execution for 80% of the services. I'm not talking about digitization, I'm talking about services that will run in one stop, in 1 second, or even in zero stop, because the well-designed process, it shows that most of the well-designed processes are also proactive. So we don't even need the one stop. We can run it without, let's say, the citizen having in mind to ask for it. And then many services will be rendered obsolete and will be phased out. And I think that this will be one of the first real applications, as we say, by design of the once-only principle. Because most of the time, what are you trying to do is to reconfigure things. Ah, already. Okay. And of course, all data and the metadata and everything will be done in Greek and English. This is an imperatum for the contractor that we have this project. I call it, as you see, maybe the biggest BPR project in European Union today. So, what are the tools that we have? We, of course, thank ISA and all the units for some very important assets. Of course, we know the CPSVAP model, which is a rather simple initial now yet way to describe a service. I was part of the team, and I know that we said, let's make something simple, and maybe it doesn't fit everything, but we need to extend now on that. And then we have a lot of control vocabularies already through the ADMS, and we have also some initial work done with IMAPs for evaluating the interoperability of a service, but not the design itself, as I said. So, at the end, we will make maybe the biggest repository of services in the country. Of course, we're going to work together with the work done and presented by Estonia before. And then rely a lot on simulation, because you see, what can you really tell about how the process is going to run out of your mind? So we need an infrastructure that can simulate maybe in parallel 100,000 service requests per day in the whole environment. And then we know what is better or worse. And finally, and that's the finishing line of my talk, this service reweaving algorithm. I don't like the word re-engineering. It sounds a little bit very, very strict. Reweaving is better. We weave again the process. Plato said, the art of governance is like the art of the one who is weaving garments. So this reweaving algorithm is important. And also we find this idea of service archetypes. You know what? Even if you apply for a passport or you apply to get your new house built, you're asking for the same thing, to be included in some kind of controlled registry. So getting into the registry should look the same. Taking a permit should look the same. Getting or making a payment should look the same across municipalities, states, and maybe continents also. So this is the work for ISA. If we want to tackle organization and interoperability, we need to put our hands into the mud a little bit and be much more prescriptive on the type and per type of service than before. That's all for the moment.
Thank you.